Affinity Photo has a macro feature where it records steps, but it's not the same as Photoshop Actions. There's quite a few differences. Now I'm just going to go and create a very basic design here, maybe a donut. It could be any other design. So quickly create a shape like that. And I'm going to go with, say, no stroke and also a fill, maybe with a gradient. So I'm just going to apply a gradient, something like that. Doesn't matter. You could create any design, circles, squares, whatever. Now you can see over here, layers and also macro. Macro, to record a macro, just got a little red there, that's the record. So I'm just going to start recording this design. So record. Now I'm going to quickly go down to over here to effects, just the bottom of layers, so effects. I'm just going to add a bit of 3D outer shadow. So outer shadow and set radius, offset and intensity. So you can see a nice shadow effect there. Very decent one. And also 3D, a feature that's not in Photoshop. Love to see this. So it's a nice 3D effect. Not that it sort of extrudes or anything. And once you've done that, you've got all these settings, click close. And you can see that's been recorded to the macro. So everything you change in the macro is, and all the various steps is in the macro. Now I'm going to rasterize it. So layer and down to rasterize. I want to turn it into a pattern layer. So rasterize, preserve layer effects, just turn that off. Just click there, preserve that. Because what happens then, rasterize, it saves it all in one complete set. So the shadow, the 3D, etc., is all into the design. So it's not separate as it was before. And you can see it's a pixel layer with no effects. Now I can go to layer and I can go down to new pattern layer from selection. And that's the reason why I have to turn it into pixel. So new pattern layer from selection, and you can see your pattern layer there very quick as well. And you've got, of course, this design here. I'm not going to remove that yet, because what I'm now going to do is I'm just going to go over here to the move tool. So select the move tool. And with that selected, of course, go to mirror, put mirror on. So you've got the mirror effect, and that's recorded as well, set pattern mirror. And now I'm going to apply an effect, very basic one, but you could be any effect. So distort and deform. And I'm just going to quickly deform this design. And as soon as you do that, you can see what happens. It just generates this very unusual design. You can warp it in numerous ways. Like that. And click apply. And you can also resize it, of course, move it around, rotate it, etc. All these things, all are recorded. I'm going to stop now. So just stop it by clicking the second there, and it's all saved. Now, there is an option for a library. You can add it to a library. That works okay, but it's not brilliant. That's in the view menu, studio and library. You can save it to a library by clicking there. Now I've got this design. Well, what I can do now is I can remove it. That's the hidden feature. You can remove all this. It's gone. Now, if I go and do another design, so I create a very quick design like that, say, and then run this macro, you suspect what would happen would be it would use that design. So, you know, it got, if I had obviously a stroke or a color, you got that design, that would be used. It doesn't. But the key thing is deselect. Deselect the layer. Make sure no layer selected, which seems odd, I know, but you can run it again. And then you've got the design. Very quick and easy. It's remembered everything. That's quite unusual, I think. So again, I can remove that. There is nothing now in this. I can run it again. Click there and you see you've got your design. And it will create it at the same angle, same scale, exactly each and every time. Deselect it, run the macro and you've got it again. Deselect, run the macro and you've got it again. So you can create very quickly this design. Now, of course, you can always duplicate the pattern layers as well, but it's quite weird that it does that. That's why something that's not a feature of Photoshop in any way. Those actions don't work like that. So what you can do, of course, you can select those patterns and you can go to layer and merge selected. So if you selected all of the layers, they're all pattern layers, use the merge selected and that will turn them into a pattern layer. So merge selected becomes a pattern layer. The key thing is make certain that you have mirror on for all of them. All the make sure it's mirrors on. Otherwise it will end up cutting the design in a particular way, non-seamless. So you can create very quick, lovely new pattern design there. And again, you can always then run it again. So again, deselect and run the macro, and you've got your design there again. And then you can combine that. Long as it's both, long as they're mirrors, then you can combine them very nicely. Otherwise, what happens, it's not so good. So layer and merge selected. And you can see your design there. And you can create some very complex designs very quick and easily. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.